Here in the UK, we do love a period property.
Did you ever think, Paul, that that might be ours?
From countryside houses...
God, it is huge, isn't it?
..to magnificent mansions.
It's so nice. It's lovely.
But beneath the grand facades...
The Lord and Lady with their castle.
..these derelict houses... ..are falling to bits.
Nice that the curtains are still hanging, eh?
Pushing away at that there, you can see it's just absolutely rotten.
All over the country, these historic homes...
This wallpaper was on the Titanic.
..are being snapped up at knockdown prices.
I don't think we ever imagined that we would be able to afford something of this stature.
But there are great challenges ahead.
Every single day, it's a new crisis to deal with.
I budgeted for a roof, I'm budgeted for a floor.
It's just everything at the moment. It's all too much.
For this growing army of brave and determined dreamers who want to transform these wrecks into the forever home of their dreams.
This is my favourite room.
The whole concept of the room and how it's come together.
I don't think I've really appreciated this room until now. Now it's finished.
Brick by brick.
I honestly never thought this day was going to come. I can't believe like we're actually at this point.
Room by room.
Absolutely love it.
We are a renovation nation. Today, there's all kinds of trouble and strife facing our plucky renovators.
Don't let it rest on that wood.
Tracy and Rob race to get their crumbling castle wedding ready.
It's like a, is it a swan above water. It looks very graceful over the water and then underneath it, pedaling the hell.
We meet a couple battling budgets in an Edwardian villa.
Who wants professionals to come in and do everything and you just move in and it's all perfect and lovely? Why would you want that?
Where's the character?
Precisely.
And structural shenanigans in a Cheshire mansion.
I must admit, I didn't realise how much work it would be to get rid of it.
Yeah, I just hope the roof doesn't fall down.
Central Scotland, north of Glen Eagles, in the scenic county of Perthshire. At the foot of the stunning Southern Highlands sits Culdee's Castle and its 22-acre estate. Built in 1810, the castle has fallen into a severe state of disrepair over the years, and the last resident moved out in 1968. It's going to take more than a quick vac and a lick of paint for Rob, an IT consultant, and his partner Tracy, a former events manager, to make Culdee's their dream home.
He fetched me up one weekend on a weekend to meet his family in Scotland and then said, oh, I've got you a little wild card. And we came here.
Within about 2 hours, we decided this was perhaps something we should pursue further. And 7 months later, we moved in.
The castle and grounds set them back £730,000, but to fund the renovation, they need Culdee's to work as a business and a home. They've already installed glamping pods in the grounds and have transformed the overgrown courtyard into an event space.
Every room that we do has to earn its keep. Otherwise, we'll be doing exactly the same as all of the previous people that owned this beautiful building, where they couldn't actually afford to maintain it. So that's why it's ended up in this state. So we're starting at the back and we're just slowly working our way through.
The first wedding in the fully restored event space will take place in less than a month. So Tracy and Rob need to sort out all the rooms around the courtyard for the big day. They want the rooms to be fun and functional, with a good slice of historic character that reflects this part of the world. But one room in particular still isn't ready.
So, yeah, we've got less than 4 weeks to the wedding and we have a catering team that are expecting to come in here and have lighting and power and water and it to be quite a lot cleaner and tidier. They're not expecting it to be decorated, so if we could pull something out of the bag and surprise them with a little bit more than they're expecting, that would be amazing. So it'll be all hands to the pump.
Although the scullery, which will be a kitchen for the event caterers to use, still requires a lot of work, other rooms are progressing nicely. The final pieces of hand-printed wallpaper are being hung in the cloakroom, And the Whisky Snug now has an elaborate floor-to-ceiling dresser, built using wood salvaged by Tracy from the castle. And she's well chuffed with it.
No one else would bother to sand and fill all those old mouldings from the castle. But I tell you what, they're going to look awesome on there when they're painted. And I'm quite proud that we've managed to use some of that stuff and that it's gone back in.
While Tracy sets to work spray-painting the ceiling copper, Rob's putting the finishing touches to his own labour of love, a light he's made from a reclaimed plank of wood.
I'm sure that it'll work fine. The wiring's pretty simple. I am more excited to see how it looks in there, how it fits, and how bright it's going to be. It'll either look fantastic or it'll have to come down and go somewhere else.
Rob's masterpiece has only set him back the price of four bulbs and some spare cable. But is his creation the light of Tracy's life?
That's dangling down.
What?
On this side, it's lower.
Is it?
Uh-huh. Looks all right. Just now.
Careful,
right.
Careful.
Well, no.
That was almost
I didn't
a compliment.
It's going to stop in here. The jury's still out. I need to decorate. You can leave it there for now. It might grow on me.
I think it looks good. I knew it would look good. It looks really rustic. It looks good. I like it.
Although there's still a long way to go to get the rooms ready in time for the wedding, at least now there's a glimmer of light at the end of a very long tunnel. Let's just hope it's not a train coming the other way. London is the undisputed property hotspot of the UK. Most house prices are roughly double the national average, but there are some relative bargains to be found. But only if you're not afraid of some hard work. In the thriving South London borough of Lewisham stands this six-bedroomed Edwardian property set across three floors. It was bought in 2021 for £900,000 by local couple Tade, a business development manager, and Toby, who works in compliance. They've already spent 12 months renovating the former rental property, during which time they've been living with Tade's parents.
So this is our house in Lewisham, and we still get the same feeling when we walk indoors. It's not quite the same as it was when we bought it, but still feels pretty amazing.
Yeah.
And like many London properties of this size, it comprised several bedsits, otherwise known as multiple occupancy housing. And Tade and Toby are working tirelessly to transform the property back into one amazing family home for them and their one-year-old daughter, Tia.
The main thing is ending up with a family home that we can love and enjoy. We can have our friends, we can have our family, our little girl can grow up in.
In the next few weeks, they're prioritising the kitchen so they can finally move out of Tade's parents' house to be able to start life in their new home, which they fought really hard to buy.
We looked at over 60 properties, we put in over 10 offers, and literally every property that we loved we just got priced out, really.
Yeah.
And I think that's just really common for London at the moment. Properties with good bones, everyone's after them, you know. It's a really rare find.
And it's a house with pedigree. In fact, the whole street was designed by architect Reginald C. Fry. He created these rows of Edwardian homes, but with influences from different architectural eras. The result is a pick-and-mix bag of historical features.
So this is our living room.
It was a bedroom when we first looked around, but this will be our living room.
So we've taken down this wall here.
And this was just a room.
This was, yeah, a room full of stuff.
Yeah, which it is again now. But we've tried to keep the things that we found here. So we had the exposed brick, so we've kept that.
The most important aspect of this renovation is just getting the kitchen right. I do a lot of cooking, and we're hoping to use the house for supper clubs and entertaining family and friends. So, you know, we need to make it work.
This is our future dream kitchen.
Yes.
We have been working on with an independent joiner. We found that it was the cheapest option. It's worked out really well for us. It means that we utilise every single inch of space.
They're spending a large proportion of their budget on the kitchen. It adjoins the living space and the dining room to make a big open-plan area, which will be perfect for family life and entertaining.
We are planning to have banquet-style seating on this side.
We're going to build that all ourselves, and that'll be used kind of casually for us when we're a family, just having comfy cushions on it and having our dining table in the middle. Or a really big event, we can add a table, then that's kind of one row of seating we don't have to think about.
They've meticulously thought through and planned out how every inch of this house will work, including the largest room on the top floor, which will be their bedroom.
My favourite room in the house,
yeah.
After the kitchen. In terms of what we've still got to do in here, upholstering our love seat, we're going to make a headboard for in here.
Wardrobes. We wanted to have these custom built, but those are expensive. So we've gotten them off the peg, really, and we're going to jazz them up and DIY them, build them into the floor, and make them look like they are custom built.
Who wants professionals to come in and do everything and you just move in and it's all perfect and lovely? Why would you want that?
Where's the character?
Precisely.
Coming up, an attack of the arachnids in a 200-year-old home in Cheshire.
That one, that there. How'd it go now?
Oh, God, I hate spiders.
And Tracy's to-do list for Rob gets longer.
Tell you what, you didn't finish that, did you? Look, half a job, Harry. What about that window?
That window I haven't got around to doing.
In Cheshire, close to the town of Northwich, the Grand Hertford House is in the middle of a sleepy village. Built in 1826, it once boasted 13 acres of land, tennis courts and a gatehouse. But much of the land was sold to build more houses and the servants' quarters also went to new owners. Today, this half of the building is a more manageable four-bedroom, three-reception room property and retains original features. But this beautiful building with its classic Georgian proportions is now looking its age. That didn't put off its new owners, Matt, who runs his own supercar pimping business, and Charlotte, who works in analyst relations for a tech company.
When I put my head over the fence and saw the house, I was like, wow, we need that house. I knew it was out of budget, it needed a lot of work, but we wanted it that much, we was willing to just go for it, no matter what.
We found out it was going up to modern method of auction, booked a day off work, bought a bottle of champagne in case we won it. We won it. Jumping around the living room, shouting and screaming, we got our dream house. And then it was, then we got round to viewing it and everything. I don't think we even got a survey done.
No.
So they took a big gamble and pretty much spent everything when they paid the £490,000 price tag.
It was not far off kind of where our top level budget was. And that also meant for us that a lot of the money we kind of, you know, would have put in for renovating the property we actually used on buying it anyway. So we've certainly gone all in on it.
Although Charlotte's a renovation novice, this isn't Matt's first rodeo, having already overhauled the first property he owned. With that experience, to save money, he's planning to do most of the work on the house himself. But his first job is no mean feat, as it's all structural work, starting with replacing the entire ceiling in what will eventually be their daughter Scarlett's bedroom, where they plan to create a pink paradise for their little princess.
It's a lot to do in here, isn't it?
When we bought the house, we knew something wasn't right with the ceilings. We decided we're going to have to get stuck in with Scarlett's room, and the more we took out the room, the more we realised that was wrong with it.
Matt discovered all the ceiling joists are loose and rotten, so we'll need replacing. But that's not the only problem.
So, yeah, here's the next big job. So you can see that old lintel there, timber lintel, wasn't strong enough for these joists above. So we're going to have to fit a new timber lintel, re-brick it up.
You've never done bricking before, have you?
I'm not really a bricklayer, I must say.
So how are you fancying this one?
I'll have to look online.
Why start one big job when you can do two? At the same time, they've decided to convert the loft to make it a very usable space. Easier said than done, though.
at the moment, as you can see, we've got this huge beam in the middle and it just kind of really restricts what we can do with the area. So we're going to remove the central part of this truss, support it with steel beams, and then that'll create a nice big walkway for us. And then in the other half of the loft, that space over there, it's all exposed brick at the moment, we're going to build a huge walk-in wardrobe.
But they're both a little bit worried about tackling a job many would bring in a specialist to do.
I must admit, I didn't realise how much work it would be to get rid of it.
Yeah, I just hope the roof doesn't fall down.
A week later, Matt and his apprentice Charlotte have got their hard hats on to begin removing the rotten ceiling joists. But first things first, the all-important selfie.
Right, so, yeah, basically, it sits into the wall, yeah? So right. It sits in a pocket there, but on this side, it sits on top. So as soon as we lift that, we can pull it out.
I hope I don't look as stupid as you in my hat.
So which side would you like to take?
I'm easy. I'll do whichever side you want.
As Charlotte's new to the renovation game, her nerves are starting to show.
So, I just hope I'm able to hold it and I'm not too weak where I can't support Matt on the other side.
And she doesn't get off to the best of starts.
Spider.
Forget the spider. Do you want me to move it? The spider. That one, that one. Spider gone now.
Oh, God, I hate spiders.
Job's on hold because there's a spider.
I'm petrified of spiders.
Right, you ready?
No.
With Charlotte's web dealt with, they can finally crack on.
Do you want to feel the weight?
Yeah,
come on,
go for
just
it.
Lift it up
just
feel,
go.
Just lift
go.
It up and feel the weight.
Yeah,
you happy?
Got it. Yeah.
Right, when we take it out, it needs to be smooth. Right, I'm going to walk it to me. You got it? Right, you need to get down slowly. Can you walk into that corner of the room?
Yeah.
And keep it low. Go lower. Lower, lower, lower. There we go. Let's go. Watch the wall. Right, so come with me and take the weight with me. There we go.
Ta-da! Well done.
Beautiful.
There we go.
One out.
In Perthshire at Culdee's Castle, the clock is ticking down to a wedding booking. The first in Tracy and Rob's fully restored courtyard.
Still got a lot to do, haven't we?
1 week to go. I can't believe how quickly a week to go has come round till the wedding. It's quite scary, actually. There's still so much to do. Even when Steve's finished what he's doing, there's about 2 days' worth of cleaning and resetting in here just to get it back to a state where we can bring all the bridal stuff in. There's some late nights in here this week.
Yeah.
And one unfinished job is particularly bothering Tracy.
My biggest worries, really, is it being cold and we don't manage to get the central heating finished, because you don't want to be sat eating your dinner and being freezing, do you?
But thanks to joiner Steve pulling out all the stops, they should have somewhere to cook the wedding breakfast, as the old scullery has been given a new lease of life as a catering kitchen.
It's been a busy 2 weeks. We've had the arch rendered, that still needs to be plastered. All the insulation's gone in, the plaster boarding's gone up. We've had some cupboards delivered, an oven. Got a broken door, but we have an oven. Some lighting's gone in here, just got to paint the ceiling. I'm not sure it's going to get decorated before the wedding, but it'll certainly look like a kitchen.
Nobody has so much as boiled an egg in the castle for at least 70 years. While some of the to-do list has been ticked off, many jobs remain, most of which have Rob's name on them.
I tell you what, you didn't finish that, did you? Look, half a job, Harry. I thought you said you were going to do this insulation. What about that window?
That window I haven't got around to doing, because I was just doing it when I was waiting on other stuff.
Well, you can do that today.
As Rob and Steve put their noses to the grindstone in the kitchen...
Hey, teach them everything.
Tracy sets to work in the whisky snug. The cabinets are finished and painted a deep purple. Walls are papered and the whisky bottles are proudly on display. There are just some final flourishes to add to a room where revellers can relax or chat away from the main event.
I am just putting a little bit of liquid gold leaf on my embellishments on the cupboard, just to give it a little bit more bling. So I think doing this just makes the MDF look a little bit more special. I love this stage. It feels really good to be messing around with all the pretty bits, dressing it, putting all the pictures in, little finishing touches.
And Tracy has another special touch she plans to add to each room they complete.
I've put a little picture on the wall of what this room used to be like, and I'm going to do that with every single room so that hopefully if people come and sit in a room, they can appreciate how much effort has gone into changing it, because it's not just decorating. I mean, this was an outside space.
Although there's still a mountain to climb to get the courtyard ready for the wedding, Rob and Tracy have to down tools early, as Rob has to pack for a last-minute business trip abroad.
It's going to be difficult without Rob here. I'll miss him, obviously. So much still to do. But we'll get there. It'll happen.
Really, it couldn't be worse timing, and I genuinely feel for Tracy. And the extra work responsibility she's going to have to bear just because I'm not here to support her.
Coming up, Tade and Toby's moving day edges closer, but they're missing some minor details.
The final step for us to move in, well, actually, we need running water. Oh, and the cooker.
And Matt and Charlotte need nerves of steel as friends arrive to give them a lift.
I'm pretty confident, but if it doesn't fit, it's down to me, unfortunately.
In Lewisham, business development manager Tade and Toby, who works in compliance, are desperate to get their South London Edwardian renovation to a point where they can finally move in. They're tackling many of the jobs themselves to speed up the process, as well as trying to save some money.
Look at that. I mean, come on. Honestly, I never thought DIY could make me so happy.
It's been a long 12 months since work first started, and all through the renovation they've been living with Tade's parents, along with their one-year-old daughter. So they're keen to start making this house their home.
The main thing is I don't want to live on a building site for the rest of my life. Like, I really am keen to where we can start putting those finishing touches on that do make a house a home, that do make it feel warm and cosy, even though Toby won't let me.
But one thing they do agree on is to try and get some rooms of the house finished to allow them to move in, starting with the bedrooms on the top floor.
Finally, our carpets are going down, so it should be a transformation of up here, fingers crossed. We're getting all the bedrooms done today, and then hopefully we can then start moving our stuff upstairs from downstairs and start living here within the next 2 weeks, fingers crossed. But I said that before, so. This is the most room me and Toby would have lived in together. We realised the other day our old flat fits into each floor of this place, which is wild to us. I think there'll be lots of epic games of hide and seek for the first couple of weeks as we kind of get used to having so much space.
The carpets have made an instant impact on the bedrooms, but there's still plenty more to sort to make these rooms ready for a good night's sleep. One area they've decided to splash the cash is in the kitchen. Tade and Toby both have large extended families who like to meet at each other's homes for family gatherings and parties. So the kitchen will become the heart of their home, whether there's 3 or 30 people here. Toby's the chef of the family, and he's overseeing the fitting of their brand new worktops, which set them back £1,500.
We love the marble look, but it's not practical for the amount of use that we have. Always cooking, marble stains a lot. So things like orange juice, lemon juice, red wine, turmeric, that would be a nightmare for a marble worktop. So we've gone for porcelain and really happy with the choice. It looks good, but is also more or less indestructible for kitchen.
Down, 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 down.
There we go.
So far, so good. The first piece fits perfectly.
Right now, looking at this, I'm in love. This is the biggie coming out now.
This next and final piece of this giant worktop jigsaw is for the kitchen island.
How's the top?
Good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
This one's a bit of a beast.
OK.
Porcelain is scratch-resistant, but it could still crack like an egg if it's dropped while the fitters manoeuvre it into place. Careful, careful, careful!
All right!
Woo! What a relief. With the worktops fitted, the kitchen is almost finished.
Oh, look at that. It looks gorgeous. Against the oak cabinets, it looks amazing. It's just as I imagined it.
I did say almost finished.
For me, the final step for us to move in, well, actually, we need running water. Oh, and the cooker.
But just 5 days later, after 12 months of living with Tade's mum and dad 15 minutes away in Catford, they can finally pack up and make the move.
Off to the new house?
Can you believe we're actually on our way to our new house?
I can believe it. I can believe it. It's been a long time in the making, right?
And with one of their brand new pieces of furniture assembled, Toby and Tade can't wait to try it out.
One, two, three. Oh, it's comfy.
It is really nice. This is really starting to feel like home now.
Yeah.
Sofa's in. We are in.
Honestly, I'm sitting here just looking at wires, like, oh, God, I've got to do that, I've got to fix that coving.
I don't think we're going to have time to sit on the sofa for a while.
Yeah, not for a little bit. But it's nice to know that we could sit on the sofa because it's here.
Yeah, I think you're too far away, though.
I love it.
I don't like this.
I won't hear you snoring.
Back in Cheshire, it's a busy day at their Georgian villa for supercar pimper Matt and Charlotte, who works in analyst relations in the tech sector. After removing all the old joists between the bedroom and the loft, the work today will shore up the structure of the house and mean they can think about creating a pink princess palace for daughter Scarlett, as well as making the loft a usable space to create a massive walk-in wardrobe. It's crucial Matt has got all his calculations correct.
So I take full responsibility for doing all the measuring. I'm pretty confident, but if it doesn't fit, it's down to me, unfortunately. So we'll have to rearrange this day.
At almost 5 metres long and weighing 200 kilos, the couple need reinforcements to help with the very heavy lifting.
One, two, three. How are we? Right, I'm going in, I've had enough.
It's a very heavy girder, but by having a lot of us here, that's been quite simple, hasn't it?
That was the easy bit. Slotting the beam in above their heads might work up more of a sweat.
Three, two, one, go!
Good lads, nice and slow. Don't let it rest on that wood. Go on, slow it, slow it, slow it. Well done, boys.
So Matt's measurements are spot on, but will it be level?
This is the moment of truth, isn't it? Oh, that'll do. That'll do me.
So far, so good.
How's it going? It fit in, then?
Yes, and it's very levelled as well.
Well done.
We've got the last bit here, so let's crack on. Are we all ready? You all right? Right, we're going to have to slide it to you guys.
They get the next steel in with ease.
You all right, Greg? All right, we're in. Right, so how are you there?
And with the steel and new joists fitting perfectly, it's job done.
A big thank you for everyone helping me out today. Massive help. Really appreciate it. And one big stage done.
With the structure now solid, they can push on as they try to create daughter Scarlett her dream pink princess bedroom. Back in Perthshire, it's the day before the big day at Culdee's Castle. Rob's back in the nick of time after being away on a week-long business trip.
This time tomorrow, our bride will be walking down the aisle.
Yep.
So it is quite. There's still quite a lot to do.
Despite Rob's absence, Tracy's been working around the clock to make sure the renovations can be completed in time. She's got the kitchen looking like a kitchen, with most of the units and work surfaces ready for the caterers. But there are still boxes to unpack, and everything needs testing. And the cloakroom is ready to receive its first, customer.
I have pretty much been working from 8 o'clock in the morning when everybody arrives to probably 11:30 at night all week. It's been a tough week. I feel a lot calmer today. It's much better when he's here. It's a lot easier. We work better as a team.
Time's of the essence, and that to-do list ain't getting any shorter. Go, go, go! First up, Rob makes a start on the fairy light arch.
It doesn't help when you're scared of heights. Just trying to get the loops as tight as I possibly can so I don't have excess down here.
Usually it's the groom with pre-wedding day jitters. Here, it's the hosts.
The bar people are here and the celebrant's been here and the catering staff are here and the bridal party's here and just adds a little bit of pressure. It's like a, is it a swan above water? It looks very graceful over the water and then underneath it's pedaling like hell. And that's kind of where we are. We're running about, the headless chickens trying to look all organised and calm and in control.
Inside, Tracy has her hands full trying to organise the seating plan with the bride and groom.
Right, you stand there.
Oh, that's me.
That's you. That's you. There's your crosses. Right, stay there. Stay there. Did we have these on angles last time, Debbie?
Yes.
Yeah, we did. Yeah. Yeah, we had them on angles so that you can see. So we would have to jiggle these. Have you got a seating plan for the chairs? Other than the ones you told me about for the reservation? Okay.
With the aisle organised and the lights now strung, things are starting to take shape. But there's one part of the renovation that hasn't quite gone to plan.
This is a log burning boiler that will provide heating and hot water to this area of the courtyard. The concern I had before I went away, it did happen. Plumber pulled out all the stops, flooded the system, ready to fire up the boiler, and it started to leak.
So, with no working radiators in the whole of the courtyard and a forecast as low as 6 degrees, Rob's had to find a temporary heating solution.
I'm now having to use a log burning boiler as a log burner. It's not particularly efficient. It is actually letting out quite a bit of heat. So I'll light it first thing tomorrow. And between that and I've got a big fan blower, we should be able to get enough heat in here through the day.
For the next few hours, the couple plug away at the long list of jobs to make sure the venue is perfect for tomorrow.
I'm excited about tomorrow now, I think. The job list is getting there. It's a big day, isn't it? It's a big day for them. It's a big day for us, but it's their wedding day and it's a huge day for them and it's a privilege to host it. I love all that. I love a bit of romance.
Coming up, it's the big day for the bride, groom and Tracy and Rob.
For the castle to hear laughter is it's really emotional.
And Tade and Toby's hard work pays off.
Hello.
Yes, it's party time in their new kitchen.
Look around, it's fabulous what they've made. It's truly like a work of art.
In Lewisham, since moving into their six-bed Edwardian house, Tade and Toby have been focusing on the ground floor rooms. Tade's put the finishing touches to the lounge.
We've been living with a piece of off-cut carpet as a rug in here for the last 4 months. So then we decided to just get it turned into a rug because it's much cheaper than buying a rug. to hopefully make this area feel a bit more like a home. It is all kind of starting to come together, which is nice. It didn't feel like it would for a really long time. And it's nice now that it kind of is.
But it's the kitchen that's seen the biggest transformation on this floor. They knocked down walls and reconfigured the space to create a kitchen they're extremely proud of. And one Toby's extremely comfortable to cook in.
Our kitchen is probably my favourite space in the house. It's come together really well. From just ideas that we both had, interestingly and amazingly, actually, like, we were able to agree quite quickly on what the design was going to look like. And for me, you know, design is great, but function is more important. And I find that in this kitchen, we've managed to marry both of those things. A labour of love, it's been stressful, but we've gotten to a happy place, and now this is my happy place in the house.
Toby's rustling up some party food ahead of a big event in a few days' time. Tade and Toby are getting married, and Tade's preparing the dining room for their guests.
Today we are having a little bit of a get-together with my bridesmaids for the wedding, just to say thank you to them. So I am just sorting out the table, attempting some sort of fire arrangement.
When do you want to start, Mr. Graham?
Once everyone's here, everyone's seated.
The dining room is still work in progress, but they have created some cut-price seating by customising flat-pack shelving.
We're on the home straight now, which is always the best part of the race.
One thing I do love about this kitchen is, like, when you've got loads of stuff, you can kind of just hide it in the cupboards. Close them. No one will see the fact that it's all a little bit of a mess.
This will be one of the first times the couple have had a proper get-together in their new home.
Hello.
These look amazing.
Hi.
Oh, my gosh, I love it.
This is cute.
I love this.
I'll get back in the kitchen in a second and finish off. But it's nice also just to look at everyone enjoying the food, enjoying the kitchen, standing around the island. It's just brilliant.
After a few drinks around the sociable kitchen island, dinner is served.
Look around, it's fabulous what they've made. It's truly like a work of art.
It's really inspiring. Tade and Toby are always inspiring in everything they do. We're all so proud of them. It's the most beautiful family home, and we can't wait to just celebrate more occasions with them here.
Tade's bridesmaids give their seal of approval.
We love and appreciate you.
And the bride's also happy to reach this milestone in the renovation.
When we got this house, the thing that we always look forward to is entertaining with our friends. It's our favourite time. It's when we, I guess, feel the most like us, hanging out with them in a space that's, like, comfortable. And, you know, all these people were with us when we were in our flat and it was tiny and we were all kind of, like, squished on the sofa. So it's nice that the same people are here kind of enjoying this new kind of phase in our lives. 3, 2, 1, 1.
Now the downstairs is ready to receive guests, their attention returns to the upper floors, and their next challenge is to turn this family bathroom into one that wouldn't be out of place in a luxury hotel. At Culdee's Castle in Perthshire, Rob and Tracy's big day has finally arrived. It's not their nuptials, but they're hosting their first ever wedding in their fully restored courtyard, and the estate is a hive of activity.
OK. I am. You?
The wedding is important in more ways than one, as the renovation of the rest of the castle depends on the courtyard becoming a viable events business. So Tracy, Rob and their friend Debbie are having an early morning meeting to make sure there's nothing left to chance.
Everything's been building up to this moment. This is the wedding day. We are at the stage now where we've done everything that we can. There will be some curveballs. Whatever happens, we'll just deal with it and it'll be fine. She'll have a beautiful wedding day.
And thanks to Tracy and Rob's tireless hard work, they'll have a beautiful day in beautiful surroundings. 4 months ago, the courtyard and three adjoining rooms were empty, damp shells, some without walls or ceilings, but now the rooms are unrecognisable from their former selves. The once crumbling cloakroom is now a regal space with traditional fixtures and fittings, complemented by beautiful hand-printed wallpaper depicting the gardens of the castle. The former game room is now a grand yet cosy whisky snug, a quiet corner to enjoy a wee dram. The bold colour scheme demonstrates Tracy's eye for design, and the dresser made from reclaimed castle mouldings is the perfect place to display bottles of Scotland's most famous tipple. Their biggest challenge was the dilapidated scullery, which is now a catering kitchen with shaker-style cabinets and a traditional ceramic butler sink. The central courtyard has also had a wedding day facelift, and Tracy is thrilled with the results.
I am super proud just now of how amazing it looks in here. I'm no professional photographer, but it looks pretty cool. It's taken a while to get to this situation that we're in now, where it's all dressed and ready for guests. That just looks great, doesn't it? You're sitting in your chair here, and you've got that castle up there. Woof.
With the inside looking splendid, there's just time to put a few finishing touches around the grounds.
No, I just gotta trash the trees.
And for Tracy and Rob to change into their Sunday best before the guests begin to arrive. As the bride and groom, Joanne and Alan, exchange vows, there's not a dry eye in the house, including Rob's. Aww.
I have much pleasure in declaring you to be married and pronounce you to be husband and wife.
Party gets started, and it seems the happy couple couldn't be happier with how the day's gone.
The day's been amazing. It's all gone just perfect.
Everything's been perfect.
Mainly thanks to Joe, because I haven't done anything. But also Tracy and Robbie have been fantastic and just done. Yeah, the way it all looks today is just thanks to them.
As the wedding party dances the night away, Tracy and Rob can kick back and relax in the knowledge they've pulled off the perfect day at a perfect venue they have created.
For the castle to hear laughter from other people is it's really emotional. There's an emotional connection that I have that I hope other people have.
Tonight they can enjoy their achievements, because tomorrow the hard work starts all over again.
I think the tiredness will really hit us, won't it? And then we'll have a couple of days and hopefully do nothing and just reset ourselves and then work out what the next stage is.
Next time, Matt and Charlotte tackle their bedroom and bathroom with help from a young apprentice.
I know what's going to happen with this is Matt is going to come in here at the end of the day and do it all himself.
Rob's clan call in at the castle, but Tracy's not got time for a family drama.
I don't know what they're doing, messing around. I have to crack my whip today and make sure they get some work out of them.
And Tadde and Toby create a five-star bathroom.
I love this room. I think every time I come in here, I'm like, oh, I like it.
It's very difficult to say anything apart from it's epic.
At 5:30, it's a stag party, well, of sorts anyway, as the campsite cruisers continue their search for the perfect pitch. Next, though, an excellent day or walking on eggshells. Bed and breakfast battles in new Four in a Bed.